welcome back to the final episode of CCTV at ChemCon Asia 2017 in Beijing. With today, hazardous chemicals registration and emergency response in China, and the last Chinese characteristics from Sherry. But first, a Q&A on REACH.
We are very concerned in the automotive industry about the last tonnage band registration process. So my question is, do we have any idea of the quantity or the percentage of substances that will not be registered?
I don't either have a crystal ball. Pursue within your supply chain actively, but also follow the ECHA information on rate of lead registrant nomination.
Are those companies that are inspected or ORs, is there a public list of who you've inspected, who's in non-compliance, who's in compliance, or are they all aggregated into your reports as numbers and percentages?
A few years ago, when we already saw that some of the only representatives are just those letterbox companies, there has been an initiative started, which is called ORO. Okay, only representative organization, and they have some minimum requirements, and as soon as you are willing to fulfill and you have to sign them, then you are being part of ORO, and you will find them easily by Aunt Google or Mr. Google. It's just only a representative organization, and I would highly recommend to contact them in order to find someone taking care of his duties.
The reports, the REACH enforcement reports, are they public? Will they be publicly available?
Yes, they are.
All right. Yeah. On the ECHA website?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Time for the last Chinese characteristics from Sherry. Sherry, what is the final treasure you'd like to share with us?
Cheered. I have quite many treasures to share with you. Can I share a few more?
Sure, go ahead.
Let's start with the eight treasures. Ba Bao Cha, eight treasures tea. A Chinese traditional herbal tea originating from Yunnan, China. Eight treasures refer to the many ingredients in the tea, and it is served in a very special way. There are basically two words across the world for the tea, te and cha.
Te is the Fujian province dialect for tea. The harbors of Fujian were once major points of contact with foreign traders. Western European traders, such as the Dutch, probably have taken this pronunciation. The Dutch then spread this pronunciation of tea to Western Europe. This pronunciation gives rise to English tea, and similar words in other languages, and is the most common form worldwide.
Cha is a Cantonese word for tea. A similar story overland with Portuguese, spreading this word cha to India and other parts of the world.
Wow, only two words, but there are a lot of tea varieties and a lot of people drinking tea around the globe. Thank you for now, we'll get back to you for your final treasure. Now it's time for another cup of tea altogether. Today's interview is about hazardous chemical registration and emergency response in China, a topic I discussed with Jinhe Chen and Helen Huangfu. Everyone has NRCC's number since it is on all Chinese SDSs. Can you explain what happens when the phone rings in case of an emergency?
When the telephone bell is needed to be picked up in three bells, yeah, they need to check the information from the caller, what happened, which substance caused this happens, and which company's product, and does anyone hurt, or something like that. They need to give the chemical hazard information and the handling advice in 10 minutes. If a major accident happens, they need also to refer the information to source.
Helen, in order for NRCC to provide the right information in case of an emergency, you need to provide the right information to NRCC. What kind of information do you provide?
Normally, we will provide a product safety data sheet, which contains the product information and also including the emergency response and treatment information. It is very important to ensure that the SDS are up to date with good content information. When we first sign the service contract with NRCC, we will give them a hard copy of most up-to-date SDS. When the SDS is updated, actually the system will send a notification to NRCC informing that what product its SDS has been updated, so that NRCC would be able to download it from our online system and then add this most up-to-date version into their own database for treatment in the future.
Please watch the complete interview on our website and YouTube channel. And now it's time for the statement of the day. Today's statement is related to global risk assessment approaches. With us at CCTV today is Leticia Reis de Carvalho from the Brazilian Ministry of Environment. Leticia, welcome.
Thank you, Thierry. I'm very happy to be here.
Leticia, the Brazilian government recently went through an extensive research process to see which global or local, in that case, risk assessment approach would fit Brazil. Can you share a little bit about that process?
We are working very hard at home to approach different systems, and I would say that the Canadian risk assessment approach now is being our major inspiration in this process.
And why did you choose this approach?
It fits to our governmental conditions and also fits very well to our industry. So I think both sides of this equation would be very well attended if you use it this as a reference.
And your statement is?
A risk assessment approach of a country should fit local industry.
Perfect. Please share your answer with us. Leticia, thank you very much for being with us this week. Time to say farewell to Sherry.
We started this week with the beautiful Beijing building. I'd like to end with one as well, the China National Stadium, the Bird Nest. It was built in 2008 for Beijing Olympic Games. There are some Chinese characteristics linking with the 2008 Olympic mascot. They are Bei Bei, Jing Jing, Huang Huan, Ying Ying, and Ni Ni. All the five mascots linking together form a sentence, Beijing Huan Ying Ni. Welcome to Beijing. The five mascots correspond to five natural elements, and apart from Huang Huan, to four popular animals in China. They also represent the five colors of the Olympic rings. Also, they bear good wishes, as it was traditional in ancient China to transmit wishes by means of symbols or signals. For example, Ni Ni, the swallow, she is green and her wish is good luck. Her design is inspired by Chinese kites. Pronunciation of the swallow in Chinese is Yan, and the ancient name of Beijing was Yanjing. I'd like to wish you all good luck. Cheered, it's been a great pleasure being your local reporter of the 24th ChemCon event. Also, the 24th Winter Olympic Games will be organized in Beijing. In 2022, Beijing will host that event. It will become the first city organizing both Summer and Winter Olympic Games. I hope one day ChemCon will come back soon. From Beijing, China, this is Sherry for CCTV.
Thank you very much. Zaijian. Now it's time for the final forecast.
Bye.
This morning we will focus on global supply chain transparency issues and supply chain communication. We will also look into major accident prevention, control and response. After that, we put our spotlight on global risk assessment approaches in the Americas, Europe and Japan. And our grand finale, the practical implementation of GHS. Thank you for watching. It was our privilege sharing all the news with you this week. We hoped you liked it and we look forward to seeing you in New Orleans.